June the 2nd last year, and an unknown arsonist starts four separate fires at Vancouver flatlets in Bayswater. Two people are killed, 20 are taken to hospital, the building badly damaged. This was Terence Goffsold's room. He was one of the lucky ones 7 months ago, escaping uninjured.
The night of the fire was absolutely terrible. There was people climbing from the windows and down the drain pipes.
Do you think there was more that could have been done?
They could have turned around as well. Sprinklers, hose pipes, but they didn't.
The arson attack was impossible to predict, but the housing organisation Shelter also believed the building could have been safer. They commissioned two independent environmental health officers to look at the building. Their lengthy report concluded, "We regard the means of escape here as so poor that had we inspected on behalf of the local authority, we would have recommended urgent action to secure major improvements."
The main problem was there was no primary protective staircase. And without that, that basically means that people just can't escape from the fire. And the protection for the tenants was actually very low. There wasn't proper fire alarms. There wasn't any emergency lighting system. And basically all the key factors you need to escape from a fire and be protected from it, a lot of them were missing.
Today, the insurance assessors were back at Vancouver flatlets, but Shelter's concern is now with similar properties in the Westminster area. There are more than 4,500 of them.
And we're just terribly concerned that there's going to be other buildings like this who've also been given a clean bill of health and, in fact, are a danger to the inhabitants.
Tonight, Westminster's housing chairman Pat Kirwin denied all of Shelter's main charges and stood by a council report which gave the building a clean bill of health before the fire. She accused Shelter of playing party politics with people's lives. Meanwhile, several former residents who've not been offered alternative permanent homes since the fire have threatened to take Westminster Council to court. Paul Green in Bayswater for Thames News.